Alongside my partner Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, when you and I were going through our final run-throughs at breakfast, we kept thinking tonight we're going to get to see a couple of very good passing offenses.
And we're talking about both sides having multiple receivers that could have an impact on this game. It's not just one guy that's going to make all the plays. If you take him away, maybe number two, number three, they make the big plays that impact who wins the game.
Tyreek Hill on the return. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Now the first carry here for Tom Gurley. From scrimmage, how about that? Talk about setting a tone.
And people always talk about doing exactly that in the first 5 minutes of the game, the first offensive and defensive series. Who's going to gain an advantage? Well, we saw exactly what happened there. A tone was definitely set by the offensive team.
This will be taken in at the one. And bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Seven leaves it with a second and three.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play call to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber who runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
On second down, Williams. And he'll scratch out only about a yard after the 32.
Doug Brooks diagnosed that play so well, just like he did back in the day. Over 1,700 career tackles in route to being a first ballot Hall of Famer.
Heck of a guy off the field as well, winning the Walter Payton Man of the Year Award in 2000. They'll try and run for it. Here's Williams. It goes as a gain of eight and moves the chains.
Plenty of things to talk about here, Carter, but to me, their defense gave up a touchdown on the first drive. How about how they're responding, coming back? That's a big third down pickup to keep their drive alive.
Throwing now, Wilson on first down. Throws a quick hitter on the slant, that's complete. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So if they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball second down.
Pushing forward for three up to the 48.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense, because you're excited about hitting him in the first half, maybe not so much in the second half, as some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Third and two, now Wilson. They'll set up the screen. This is Williams. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back in the 46. Calling a loss of two on the play. And that's going to make it fourth down. Here's Wilson. He gets it to Brown. Good play. before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. How about them biting off 15 yards there on the fourth down attempt and keeping the drive alive? And he'll take this one down to the 36. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it will be second down.
What's the old expression, 3 yards in a cloud of dust? In this case, it's dust-covered pellets.
And a double team, and it's intercepted. Rob Woodson with a pick. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line.
Well, I'm not sure I've seen a better all-around athlete than Rob Woodson. I mean, he was at Purdue at the same time I was at Tennessee. He was obviously way better than me. His last game at Purdue, the coach let him play both ways. He played 137 plays that day. Returned punts, kickoffs, had 10 tackles on defense, had a pass broken up and a forced fumble, and 236 all-purpose yards on offense. And he kept the old record bucket by beating Indiana in that game.
And not too much going there as he'll get it up to the 23-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there, and it'll be second down. To throw, Vic. He cannot get away. Down goes Vic. John Lee. Coming hard on the blitz. He dumps him for a loss of 8. And here the pressure from the outside linebacking spot.
And normally when that happens and they're able to get home, these other guys on his team helped him out a lot. But they occupied people to allow it to be no less than a one-on-one situation allows him to get home.
Third and long for Vic. In trouble, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. Well, they went with the nickel. They throw an extra defensive back. Coverage was very good.
Yeah, it was exactly as you would expect. A passing down, bringing the nickel package. Just as you described, the coverage was excellent and allowed one of the linemen to end up getting to the quarterback.
Returnable now for Winston. 21 yards. Well done on the return. And this offense, they're going to have an excellent field position. They take over for the first and 10 on the short side of the field. Back onto the field comes the offense for the Madden Legends. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. Of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get them down the field.
Yeah, unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once it threw the interception and finished off the drive, it does them no good to go back and say, well, you know what, a good one going. Finish things off. That's how we can get it done.
And that will fall incomplete. Oh, they took a shot there on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. They go play action now. Wilson. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete.
It's never a bad idea to try and get it to Antonio Brown, but there must be a little bit of the Madden curse going on for our cover athlete here. Hasn't been able to get that elite separation that we're used to seeing from him.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. They need to avoid the big play, but he just got a big one right there.
He can't relax, you know. You talk about it. As the game progresses, still opportunities, and he took advantage of one more.
And now the Rams are up on things as they want a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Second and goal. It's second and goal. Back to the 8-yard line now. On second down, here's Wilson. Flush to his right. And touchdown run. And the Madden Legends with the extra point can tie this football game. Boswell good with the extra point. And we are tied at 7. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Well, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. First down, Vic. On the target over the middle of the hill. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion and would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and he passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play